Hi friends, I Chef Archana welcome you all to Talaglal's Kitchen. Today I'm going to show you one of the famous Indian mithai recipe named Moti Chur ke Laddu. So let's start making Moti Chur ke Laddu. For that we need to make the batter first. I've taken your besan ka atta. To this we'll add some baking powder. So now we'll add a pinch of edible orange food color. As you know, in the market you get orange as well as yellow color. So today we are going to make the orange one. Now we'll add some milk. Here I've used some cold milk. Give it a nice mix. And here the batter is very, very important. We need to make a pouring consistency batter. And I'll keep on mixing so that I get a lump-free mixture. Don't forget to use a whisk. This will help you to get a smooth consistency. So our batter is ready. So now you can see here the consistency is pouring. And here I've used approximately 3/4 cup of milk. So this is the perfect consistency we are looking for. So now let's start making our bundi. Now here I've taken a bundi jara which is traditionally used. You can also use the regular one, but make sure the handle is long enough and you don't burn yourself. So today I'm going to use the traditional one. And here I've already kept the ghee to heat. Yes, I'm going to fry this bundi today in ghee. So I'm just going to keep the jara over it. Take a ladle full of batter, pour it over it and just tap like this. See, you can see the bundi is falling down so beautifully. That's it. And I'm just going to wash this jhara. So every time you're going to fry a new batch, you need to wash the jhara. See, you can see the bundis have come so nice. So let's remove. So now I'm going to show you one more. Before that, I'll just wash my jhara first. After washing, make sure you wipe it thoroughly so that there's no droplets of water. So now let's make one more batch. Place your jhara over it. Just tap it like this so that all your bundis fall down. And here you must be thinking, why am I just taking a spoon and just rolling it over? If I'm going to do like that, the strings will fall down and not the bundis. So yes, it's done. So let's put this for wash again so I can make one more batch out of this batter. So now in the same way, I'm going to fry the remaining bundis. All the bundis are fried and ready. As the name says, Moti Chur, that means we have to coarsely grind this. So now let's grind this in a mixer till coarse. So the bundis are crushed and ready. So I can just show you here, the bundis have crushed properly, as like it's not very big and not very small. So let's start preparing the next step, that is making the sugar syrup. To make the syrup, first I'm going to take 1 cup of sugar, little lime juice. Again, I'm going to add 2 pinches of edible orange food color. And to this, I'm going to add 1/2 cup of water. Yes, the measurement is very, very important for the sugar syrup. And now I'm going to switch on the flame and I'm going to keep a timer exactly for 5 minutes. And I'm going to cook the sugar syrup on a medium flame. And make sure you're stirring it occasionally. It's been 3 minutes. We are going to cook for another 2 minutes. It's been 5 minutes. I will switch off my flame. Now to this, I'm going to add some nuts, some pistachios, melon seeds. Yes, which will give a nice crunch in the laddu, saffron, cardamom powder and few drops of rose essence. I'm going to mix this well and now I'm going to transfer this on the slowest flame because we need to cook the bundis again. Now we'll add the bundis, the coarsely crushed bundis, and I'm going to continuously stir it for approximately 3 minutes. You just need to keep on mixing it continuously. It will soak up all the sugar syrup. It's been 3 minutes. You can see here it started leaving the sides. Now I'm going to just switch off the flame. Now I'll just cool this slightly, approximately for 10 minutes. It's been 10 minutes. You can see the mixture is also nicely thickened and it's also cooled down slightly. So let's start shaping our laddus. For that, I'm just going to grease little ghee on my palm. Take a small portion of the mixture. Keep it on my greased palm. and just roll it lightly. And our moti chur ke laddu is ready. So I'll just keep this in the serving plate. And make sure every time you roll a laddu, always grease it with little ghee. So our second one is also ready. So now in the same way, I'm going to roll the rest of the laddus. So all our motichur laddus have been rolled and ready. All you need to do is make this in your kitchen right away. But make sure you do not serve this immediately. Keep this for 2 to 3 hours and re-roll the laddus again and then serve. Wish you all a very happy Diwali and a prosperous new year. I'll come back after Diwali. Bye-bye.
Download the Tarla Dalal app on your Apple and Android devices. Follow us on the Facebook at tarladalal.com. If you enjoy our recipes, click like. To see more of my recipes, click here. Please share your comments. I would love to hear them. I'm waiting for them.